Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and this is Han. Today, I will show you how to call the COVID-19. But before I start, I would like to take this opportunity on YouTube to say thank you to our frontline doctors, nurses, and medical workers who are putting themselves at risk in order to save life. We will be forever grateful to them. Also, I will go live on this channel this coming Sunday, May 3rd at 9 a.m. Eastern Time, for the first time, just to show you how to call an ED record and see how it goes. So please come and join me. Alright, without further ado, let's get started. Inside this video, first, I will tell you the outpatient and inpatient coding guidelines regarding the COVID-19. Then, I will show you how to code the COVID-19. Next, to make it fun, we will play who wants to be the best coder. And lastly, I wouldn't want to disappoint you, so I will give you some homework to take home. Before I introduce the coding guidelines, I want you to know the difference between the outpatient and inpatient services. Simply put, it depends on how long a patient must remain in the facility and where they have the procedure done. For the outpatient, there will be no admission. The patient usually stays less than 24 hours. So if you are an outpatient coder, you probably would call for the pain clinic, wound clinic, ED department, ambulatory surgery center. On the other hand, for the inpatient, it requires the admission to the hospital floors. For example, if you are having a serious procedure or a surgery that requires a large incision, then the chances are you are more likely to stay overnight in the hospital under the supervision of a nurse or a doctor, just to make sure that your vital signs are stable, there is no post-op bleeding or any complication related to the surgery. These are common inpatient procedures: open heart surgery, brain surgery, joint replacement, etc. There's one thing that I want you to remember is that if you call an observation record, it's still considered an outpatient, although you may find that some patients do stay overnight in the hospital, but still less than 24 hours, so be aware of that. I hope that you have a better idea now. This slide is about dealing with uncertain diagnosis. Let's say you are coding a record and the physician documents the final condition or disease using the terminology like probable, suspected, likely, questionable, possible, still to be ruled out, or other similar terms indicating uncertainty. According to the ICD-10-CM official coding guidelines, if the record that you are coding is an inpatient record, then you code that condition or disease as it existed or was established. In contrast, if this is an outpatient record, then stop. Do not code that uncertain diagnosis. Instead, you code the sign and symptom or abnormal test results, or other reason for their hospital visit. For example, if the final diagnosis is documented as possible pneumonia, for the inpatient, you call the condition that it was established. In this case, it's unspecified pneumonia. For the outpatient, do not call the possible pneumonia, call the sign and symptom instead. And it could be a cough, fever, sore throat, etc. Now you understand why I want you to know the difference between the inpatient and outpatient services. All right, what is the code for the COVID-19? The World Health Organization broke down the name of both the disease and the virus itself. The disease is named COVID-19, short for coronavirus disease. And the virus is named is SARS-CoV-2, short for Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, Coronavirus 2. The 19 in COVID-19 stands for the year the virus was first detected, which is last year, 2019. As you already know, the novel coronavirus was identified in Wuhan, China, in December last year, and then it has spread throughout the world, sending billions of people into lockdown. Million people have been infected, and more than 200,000 people killed by this virus as of today. In January 2020, the World Health Organization declared COVID-19 a global pandemic, and they also create the emergency code U07.1 for the COVID-19. In the US, the CDC, Center for Disease Control and Prevention, incorporate this code into ICD-10-CM. As of April 1st, you find the tabular index listed U07.1 COVID-19 in the new chapter, Chapter 22, titled Codes for Special Purposes. The section U00 to U49 is for new disease of uncertain etiology or emergency use only. If you remember from my lesson 1, ICD-10-CM code structure, the code consists of 3 to 7 characters, and the first character is always an alpha character except character U. That is because it wants to save this section for new disease or emergency use. How to code the COVID-19 cases? First, U07.1 will be assigned for those who have positive COVID-19 test results or presumptive positive COVID-19 test result. For cases where there is an actual exposure to someone who is confirmed to have COVID-19 and the exposure patient either test negative or the test result are unknown, use code G20.A2A, contact with and exposure to other viral communicable disease. For case where there is a concern about a possible exposure to COVID-19, but this is ruled out after evaluation, in other words, they don't carry the virus, then use code G20A1A and count for observation for suspected exposure to other biological agent ruled out. For asymptomatic individuals, asymptomatic means no sign and symptom, who are being screened for COVID-19 and no exposure to the virus, and the test results are either unknown or negative, you assign G11.59 and count for screening for other viral disease. This sounds like we are going to use this code for many people who may require to be tested before going back to work. We don't know yet. It may or may not happen. Let's wait and see. Last, for patients presenting with signs and symptoms associated with COVID-19, such as cough, fever, etc., but a definitive diagnosis had not been established, then we just call the presenting sign symptom. For example, cough, fever, sore throat, etc. All right, we're almost done. One more slide for the guideline, and that'll be all. when COVID-19 missed the definition of the principal diagnosis, CoU07.1 should be sequenced first, followed by the appropriate code for associated manifestation, except in the case of pregnancy patient. For a pneumonia case confirmed as due to COVID-19, you assign U07.1 first, then J12.89 autoviral pneumonia second. For a patient with acute bronchitis confirmed as due to COVID-19, you assign U07.1 first and then J20.8 acute bronchitis due to other specified organisms second. If the COVID-19 is documented as being associated with the lower respiratory infection, you assign U07.1 first and then J22 unspecified acute lower respiratory infection second. For ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome due to COVID-19, you assign U07.1 first and then J80 acute respiratory distress syndrome second. Well, finally, I believe I covered them all. Sorry if I book you asleep. To wake you up, let's play Who Wants to Be the Best Coder. This is a $1,000 question. What is the correct branching order into the lungs? A. Bronchioli, trachea, bronchi. B. Trachea, bronchi, bronchioles. C. Trachea, bronchioli, bronchi. And D. Trachea, epiglottis, bronchioles, bronchi. And the correct answer is? Well, please book your answer in the comment below the video. Alright, this is your homework. Code the following diagnosis. First, pneumonia due to SARS associated with coronavirus. B. Sepsis due to SARS associated with coronavirus. I'll give you the answer next video. That's all for now. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to leave me a comment, a feedback, share, and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a great day.